Welcome back, Gifted Garage. It's moving day. If you saw the end of my last video, I got a new space. I can do bigger and better things. Probably not, but this is a life upgrade. So, I already got all my stuff out of here. It was easy. I didn't have a lot of stuff to move or get rid of at all. So now I just got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 things left to move. You know, the stuff with wheels that may or may not run and drive the 20 something miles I need to move them. So I need to get this out of the way first. And it's raining. And then we get to try and drive all this junk to the new place.
The next day.
So, it's a beautiful day, and my dumpster is gone. So, time to move some cars. Last time I drove this, it overheated to like 260 degrees. Pretty sure that radiator's plugged. Threw in the battery from the old race car that I took out before my road trip. So I hope it starts. Hope my windshield wipers work. This should be the easiest one to move. All right. Got a little box of tools, some jumper cables, and we'll see how it goes. Help! This is hopefully the easy one. Should probably get gas.
good.
She hot.
Why though? Top's hot. Bottom's warm. Lot of pressure. All right, so if I can make it 6 miles every time, might be a little while.
Hello. Are you here to save me?
Yes. Bro. What you got, babe? We need it?
Yeah, we got some heat. We cooled down here. 206. Great. She's gonna follow me for a little while. In the dinosaur. 204.
A few moments later.
It's gonna be a long trip. What was that, like 2 miles?
Yeah, like 2 miles.
Too tired. I just gotta keep going.
I don't need to use my AAA gold membership or anything.
Calculations are correct. I just need to stop like 8 more times to make it.
Later.
I'll just stop on the side of the highway every mile and a half. the heater core back up real quick. Start running the blower motor too. I thought this was a high spot holding an air bubble, so I deleted it. I don't know. I'm just filling up my jug with dirty side of the highway puddle water. If the radiator wasn't plugged, it is now. Let's try it again. Ooh, we down to 195 now. We're down to 197 now. Let's go. A minute. I don't know why I don't just take the one that runs, but this one's next. This one now, because it's been sitting here idling for, I don't know, almost an hour now, no problem. So we'll just take that one. So I just fixed that, you know, real quick. Topped it off. No more coolant leak, I hope. Ugh.
my temperature gauge in here. Doesn't really work 100%, you know, accurate to tell me what temperatures are, but the pump on that transmission does not sound good. I kind of have brakes. Oh yeah, no power steering. This is gonna be tons of fun. Very large puddle of water. I'm sure that's fine. Sometimes it bogs hard. We'll be right back.
That's two.
All right.
Now it's dark.
Hopefully we don't have any surprises with this one.
Should be relatively straightforward ride.
So I had to admit defeat yesterday.
Can't have nothing nice. That won't start. The carburetor on this thing is like Old Faithful.
But I needed to move this anyways. So we'll just haul that, I guess. I hate trailers.
But I need one for this. This is a 2003 Silverado SS chassis. So it's LQ9 6-liter all-wheel drive.
It's for future project.
But it doesn't fit on a trailer. And I gotta
load it myself. Should be interesting.
So you'll notice it doesn't quite fit. So you gotta strap the front.
And I'll show you the secret. You just gotta tell them you're towing like a Honda Civic when you get the trailer. Because if I told them I was towing this, they'd say, nope. All right, one more down. Let's go get another one. So now I got this piece of junk, which be nice to get it running. To at least drive onto the trailer. Because if I get it running, I could drive it. But then I'd have to leave my truck here. I don't have any help today. It's a lot of extra back and forth. But I think I got some carburetor stuff in here. Yeah. So hopefully, and that's just the little needle and seat and stuff. Uh-oh. I mean, that's not stuck. This gasket is junk. So I got a couple nylon ones. I don't know if that's kosher for this, but they fit. Way down. I don't want you flooding. I've got the worst jumper cables ever.
One eternity later. Thank you.
thing just backfired when I shut it off and spun the blower backwards. It's not good. This thing needs a 6-liter truck motor and some turbos. Immediately. One more, all lined up.
Well, only a couple things left.
I'm still surprised that the Cutlass fired up and drove off the trailer. I didn't film that. I was just trying to get it done. Whatever that backfire happened when I pulled it onto the trailer. Don't know what that was about. But it fired up and drove back off.
This thing's been charging forever.
Now I'll show you the wrong way to jumpstart a beautiful Harley Davidson. Take your cover off, and then you pull the boot off of the starter, and then try your hardest not to do that.
So that's it.
The end of this chapter. I mean, this place served its purpose while I was here. Can't forget my flag. Kind of a pointless video, but had to move all my junk, and now I know what's wrong with all my junk. The dart is actually not bad, just the brakes are sticky and they're drum brakes and they have a death single pot master cylinder. The Cutlass carburetor's junk. It just needs a LS, like 6-liter turbo, fuel injected, you know, the old dinosaur C10. Hoping it just has a plugged radiator and I can remedy that pretty easily. So I got some projects ahead. And the race car from that road trip to Florida. If you haven't seen that, check that out. So that's it for this episode of GIF the Garage, where GIF did stuff. I'm GIF. See ya.